Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Today we are going to be talking about my Kindle Paperwhite. I did a video on my channel about a year ago talking about this guy right here. You guys seem to like it. It's my most popular video on my channel. So I thought I would do an updated review over a year later just to check in and let you guys know how much I love my Kindle. In today's video, we're going to be talking about the pros and cons of my Kindle, as well as my Kindle Unlimited recommendations and my Kindle Unlimited TBR. With that being said, let's get started on today's video. Okay, so let's talk about my Kindle in general. The 2022 Kindle Paperwhite, they just released the Kindle Paperwhite 2024. I don't think you can get this version anymore. I might be getting the new Kindle ColorSoft. Like this video and comment down below if you guys wanna see an unboxing and a review of that. It just released and it's the first Kindle ever that is in color. Have not decorated my Kindle since my last video. I plan to though, I just haven't gotten around to it. Love the case that's on my Kindle. I will link my Kindle down below if it's still available to buy, or if it's not available to buy, I will link the 2024 version down below in the description box, as well as my clear case and my pop socket. So pop socket is a must with the Kindle because it just makes it so much easier to hold it so you can read it in bed and whatnot. So I definitely recommend getting a pop socket. This is what mine looks like. Okay, my pop socket is perfect for this time of year because it's spooky season and it's literally a skeleton that says, "Go away, I'm reading." If you can't tell already, I love skeletons to decorate with. In the background, there is a picture of a skull with butterflies surrounding it as my wall decor. I also have guitar stickers, so we have Rhysand and Farrah. Oh my god, in my last video I said Rhysand because the whole time that I was reading Akatar I called Rhysand Rhysand. I just thought that was more fitting, so I'm sorry. And then I have the Night Court library card, I have all the seven courts, and then I have a court of Smut and Wingspan. And if you read Akatar, I just thought that was like the most clever sticker ever at the time. I don't know, I just put that on my Kindle. It's all about the exterior of my Kindle. Let's get into the pros. My first pro for my Kindle is the battery life. I'm not exactly sure. Let me actually look this up. The battery life on this thing is insane. I'm not exactly sure if this is accurate for the 2022 version. If it's not, it's definitely true for the 2024 version, but it says online that the Kindle battery life is up to 10 weeks. That's true because I know I read Crescent City 1 and half of Crescent City 2 without my Kindle dying. And if you know the length of those books, those are both two 800 page books. And I read about 1200 pages and I'm pretty sure it took me like, I think it took me like 48 hours to read Crescent City 1. I'm not really sure. Just take my word for it that the Kindle battery life is absolutely insane. Another pro of the Kindle that's very obvious is the size and how portable it is. I love that it's super thin and it just fits in my purse and I can take it everywhere I want to go. Another pro of my Kindle is that I get to read in the dark. Really, a big part of why I sometimes prefer my Kindle over my physical books is that I can read my Kindle in the dark. I love reading at night. I think it's so relaxing. And yeah, that's all I have to say about that. Another huge pro about this is that you can change it to light mode or dark mode, just like how you can change your iPhone from light mode to dark mode. You can also adjust your font size of the text that you're reading. My favorite pro ever is that you can personalize your Kindle. So at the top, you can have the time at the top so you know what time it is as you're reading, as well as you can personalize it. Okay, I don't know why it's not working. I'm trying to show you guys, but it's not working. But anyways, take my word for it. You can also personalize how much time you have left of a chapter at the bottom, or you can change it to how much time you have left of the entire book, or you can change it to the page count at the bottom left of your Kindle. It's not working. I don't know why it's not working, but of course it's not working as I'm filming this video. Another pro of the Kindle is that, I don't know how this works, it's like magic, but you actually read faster on the Kindle. And someone tested it, I forgot where I saw it, I think it was on TikTok. Someone tested out reading the physical copy of a book versus the same book on their Kindle, and they actually read, I wanna say like 10% or 20% faster. I'm not really sure, but you definitely do read faster on your Kindle. Another pro of the Kindle is that you don't strain your eyes as much as you would as an iPad or a phone. I think it just has like regular blue light, or I think it has like blue light protection on it or something. I'm not really sure, but you definitely don't strain your eyes as much. Another perk I love is the dictionary definition. So while you're reading on your Kindle, you can highlight a word, and since it's connected to the Wi-Fi, it pulls up the definition of the word that you selected, which I think is pretty cool because a lot of the times when I'm reading, I don't know the definition of certain words and I'm always curious, but I just usually skip right over the word and just, it just leaves my mind as I'm reading. Last pro that I could think of for the Kindle is that it's very discreet. So if you love reading spicy romance books or dark romance, no one needs to know what you're reading in public, which I absolutely love. The only con that I can think of for this video is that sometimes it takes a long time to load stuff. For me, depending on how fast your Wi-Fi is, sometimes it takes forever, and sometimes it's kind of a little bit glitchy, but not... Sometimes I would say it's glitchy, but overall not really. I don't have many complaints with the Kindle. I love it. Now let's get into my Kindle Unlimited recommendations. I am pleasantly surprised by how many books have been added since I became a subscriber of Kindle Unlimited. Honestly, I feel like only 10% of my TBR isn't on Kindle Unlimited, so that's a really good amount. A lot of the books that I bought originally when I started my reading journey weren't on Kindle Unlimited, and now they're on Kindle Unlimited. So I'm like, why did I buy those? I should have just waited, but I don't know. I just think there's a lot of books on Kindle Unlimited. So if you're new to reading, definitely buy Kindle Unlimited first before you buy a bunch of books that you don't know if you're gonna like. The first book I'm gonna recommend to you guys is Pretty Girls by Karen Slaughter. This is my favorite thriller ever. It's very dark, so read trigger warnings before you read this book. But it's about two girls, Lydia and Claire. They have an estranged relationship because 20 years ago, I think 10 to 20 years ago, their sister Julia disappeared, and no one knows why. The case went cold until Claire's husband is murdered. His murder case opens up a lot of clues about Julia's case, so then they go down this rabbit hole and try to find what actually happened to Julia. Just absolutely love this thriller. Another Kindle Unlimited recommendation is Anything by Freida McFadden. If you love thriller, or if you want to dabble in thriller and don't know if you like thriller or not, definitely check out one of Freida McFadden's works, especially her Housemaid series. This series is just so easy to get into and so easy to read. Another series I'm obsessed with, and it's one of my favorite series of all time, is the Chestnut Spring series by Elsie Silver. Book one is called Flawless, and I never knew how much I needed a cowboy romance in my life as much as I needed the Chestnut Spring series. It's so cute. It's an interconnected standalone series. Every book is about a relative or a brother. Five interconnected standalones in the Chestnut Spring series. They're not all cowboys, so you don't have to worry about every single book being a cowboy romance and it being similar to the others. It's just like the best found family story. You fall in love with the characters the more you go on in the story. I promise, if you don't like book one, which is Flawless, you will absolutely love Heartless by Elsie Silver, which is book two. Another series that I just fell in love with and I just started and I wish I started sooner was the Winnie City series by Liz Tom Ford. This is Mile High, The Right Move. Yeah, Mile High, The Right Move, Caught Up, and Play Along. They're interconnected standalones. I've only read the third and the fourth book, which is Caught Up and Play Along, which I feel like if you're going to not read the first two books, definitely read the third first and then the fourth, because they're about two brothers. These are spicy sports romance books. The first book is about... I know the first book is about a NHL player, and then the second book, I have no idea what kind of, I want to say he's, no, I don't know. I don't know what kind of, I don't know what kind of sports player he is, but the third and the fourth book are about two baseball player brothers, and they're just so good, and you just have to take my word for it. I'm not going to say much. The second The third book, Caught Up, is a single dad trope, and then the fourth book is a fake dating trope, but actually it's a fake marriage trope, and you would think that's so corny, but it was so well done. Just take my word for it. The Harry Potter series is also on Kindle Unlimited, and Yours Truly by Abby Jimenez is one of my favorite romance books of all time. It's a standalone book, but it is a interconnected standalone. Do you notice the pattern? I really love interconnected standalone series. Honestly, it's been so long since I read Yours Truly. Honestly, it's one of my favorite romance books of all time, but I can't remember everything that happens, if I'm being really honest. I know it's about two doctors. It's about Brianna and Jacob. They're both doctors. I think they're both competing for the head position of the OR because the director's leaving or something like that. I forget, but the boy doctor has anxiety. The way that Abby Jimenez portrayed anxiety in the book was so well done. I've never felt, because I have really bad anxiety and I've never felt like I've read about anxiety before that described exactly how I feel. And also, Abby Jimenez in this book wrote every single trope that there is in romance, and it's so well done. Like, we have like fake dating, we have enemies to lovers, we have a lot more, and I just don't want to spoil it, so I'm not going to say that. But it was just done so well, and you would think that it would be so overdone with all the tropes, but it wasn't, so you just need to take my word for that as well. Now let's get into my Kindle Unlimited TBR. So I'm not going to get into details with these because a lot of the books that I add to my TBR, I don't exactly know what they're about. And you're going to hear a million times on my channel that I love to go into books very blindly. First book on my TBR is actually part of a series, surprise, surprise, and it's about, I want to say, it's a sports romance series. The sport is rugby, and this is the Boys of Tommen series, aka Binding 13. I've heard so much on TikTok, especially recently, and I just heard it's a life-changing series, and I can't wait to give my opinion on it. Another series, and this is a dark romance series, but I also think it's dark romance fantasy, which I don't think I've ever read a dark romance fantasy before, and this was recommended to me by my coworker. It's called Blackened Blade. I really want to read the Poppy War series, which all three just got added to Kindle Unlimited, whereas like a few months ago I only saw book one for the longest time on there, but now the whole series is on there, so it's very tempting for me to start it. And I have A Love Letter to Whiskey, which is a romance, but I feel like it's like a toxic romance series, or no, it's not a series, it's a standalone, but everyone says like you need to read it, it's life-changing. I don't know, but I love that it's a standalone because I'm literally sucked into so many series that I can't keep up at this point in time. Then we have In the Likely Event and The Things We Leave Unfinished by Rebecca Yarros. I loved Fourth Wing last year. It was one of my favorite romanticies of all time, so I really wanted to give her modern romance books a chance. And that's all I have for you guys today. If you like this video, be sure to give this video a big thumbs up. Be sure to subscribe to my channel. I post every single week. Also, be sure to leave a comment down below letting me know if you've read any of these books and which books you were obsessed with and which books you think I need to push to the top of my TBR. I have a lot on my TBR and I need to know which books I should prioritize. I will see you guys in my next video. Bye!